from module 5. That is the basic question that may be given in exam. Okay. Okay, I will discuss that later. Next, the insulation resistance of an installation should be the insulation resistance. It is not in your syllabus. Okay. It is not in your syllabus. But you can remember that the insulation resistance of earth of an installation would be nearly 1 megawatt. Okay, this one. Next, form factor is known to you. Okay, what is form factor? Tell me.
RMS value to average value.
Right, RMS value to average value. And for a pure sinusoidal wave, what is the form factor? Sinusoidal wave, what is the form factor? 1.11. okay, always remember, for a pure sinusoidal wave, okay, this kind of wave, this form factor value is always 1.11. right. Now, next, this device that converts DC source into AC, it is called what?
Inverter.
Inverter. Right. Okay. Now, next question. See, the derived expression for growth of current and decay of current through an inductor at transient state. Okay. This one already I discussed. Okay. How will the graph look like in case of inductor? It is saying,
Papa,
in case of inductor, the current value will be like this. Okay. So from this point to this point is your transient state. Okay. This is the transient state. This is the growth of the current. Right. In case of inductor, it is called the growth of the current, because see, the current is just going to be maximum. Okay. And this is called the steady state. Okay. It is called steady state. Okay. Who is now waiting? Right. And in case of capacitor, this curve is totally opposite. This is your curve. So that is called the decay of current. This one is called growth, because the current is going to be maximum. For inductor, it is called growth. And for capacitor, it is called decay of current. Okay. Next, derive the expression for resonant frequency. This one is very easy for you to calculate. Okay. Why this is called the acceptor circuit? This one is new. Why is this circuit called acceptor circuit? That means for a particular frequency, this circuit becomes resonant. Okay. So for this kind of circuit, if you apply any kind of value, if this circuit is called acceptor, that means this circuit is accepting every values. Okay, you can apply this resonance circuit for all kind of system. Right, that's why it is called acceptor circuit. What is the frequency for resonance? It equals to 1 by 2 pi root L C. Okay. Now, okay, so then the value is Norton's theorem, then the principle of operation of MCB, that is already known to you. Okay, long questions will not come in this case. Okay, okay, check this numerical. I don't know whether numerical will be given or not. I don't know. Okay, this is the numerical that you have to apply the superposition theorem. Okay, so in case of superposition theorem, what you have to remember, that you have to consider one source at a time. Right? Now, if you apply this source for first case, then at that time current source will be what? Open circuited, right? And if you apply that current source in second case, then your voltage source will be short circuited. Okay, then calculate the current flow through this 50 ohm. Okay, remember the direction always. Then add those currents that you have calculated in case of system 1, in case of case 2. Okay. Now, next one is BH curve, that is known to you, hysteresis loss, eddy current loss, is also known to you. How can you minimize it? It is also known. Okay. Next one is this one. Yeah. A 125 kVA transformer having primary voltage of 2 kV at 50 Hz, right? 182 primary and 40 secondary turns, right? So what you have to find out? Full load primary and secondary current, right? So full load primary current, how can you calculate? What is the total kVA value? 125, okay? So since power is not losing, so I can say V1 I1 equals to 125 kVA, right? So V value is known to you from here, I1 value you can calculate. Okay, similarly secondary current V2 I2 equals to 125. Okay, I am writing here V2 I2 equals to again 125 kVA. So from here I2 value you have to find out. Okay, but at that time you have to calculate the V2 value. How will you calculate? Apply the okay, so now how can you calculate the V2 value? V1 by V2 equals to N1 by N2. Okay, N1, N2 value is known to you. V1 value is known to you. So from there, V2 value you have to calculate. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so this is your 2020 question paper. Next, we are going to the 2019. Okay, I hope. Okay, let me zoom this one. Right. Now, this is the first question. If there are two bulbs connected in series and one blows out, of the following may happen. What will happen? Okay, two bulbs, they are connected in series. That means this is your one bulb. Okay.
Sir, option B.
Option
B.
B. Okay. The other bulb will also burn out. Why? Why? Tell me the reason. Otherwise, how
sir,
will
it
I
is in series, sir.
Right? It is in series, so. Suppose I am applying here.
Sir, the brightness will be lower, but the bulb will glow.
How? See, some current is flowing here. Okay, here is your voltage. AC voltage, obviously. Okay, now see, in they are in basically series. Okay, one blows out. That means what? Blows out means what? What is the meaning of blowing out? Tell me, until unless you know this meaning, you cannot answer.
Glow with a proper frequency.
No, then I will write here glow. Why will I write glow? Here it is written BLOW, blows out. That means this coil, it stops working. Okay, that means this bulb is fused. Okay, that means this bulb is fused. So since they are connected in series, it is fused means what? This wire, this conductor, that is not working. This circuit becomes open circuit. So other bulb will also stop glowing. See, the answer is D. Okay, what is the meaning? That is blow out. Blow out means what? If you check the internet, you will find out. What is the meaning of blow out? Okay. It can, then only you can answer it. Next. So the answer is here B. Okay, the other bulb also stops glowing. Why? Because this bulb just blows out. That means if this bulb was not working at all, so your total circuit becomes open circuit. So the current will stop flowing through the circuit. So that means in this first bulb, no current flow, so it will also stops glowing. Right. Is that clear? Now, second one, if the applied voltage across the lamp is reduced by 50, then the power consumption will reduce to how much? If you apply the voltage, then it means the power equals to V square by R. Okay. Now the power is reduced to 50%. So 50% is still applied, right? So your up to date voltage is 0.5 V square by R. This is your P1. This is your P0. That means this value is 0.25 V square by R. So I can write here 0.25 into P0. Okay. So the power consumption will reduce to 25% of the original consumption. So the answer will be 25%. Is that clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next one is, the form factor of a current waveform is 1, right? The shape of the waveform is there. Now you have to find out this one. Okay, the form factor, that means your V RMS by V average. Okay, I think this value will be square shape. Okay, now check that. Whether you are getting this form factor 1 for square waveform or sawtooth waveform or triangular waveform, you have to find that. Right, the sinusoidal waveform, it won't happen because the form factor for sinusoidal is 1.11. Okay? So you have to find out. I think this will be square. Now, next one is, the DC motor needs a starter during the starting to control what? To control the this one. Okay. Now, 5. DC voltage of 100 volt is applied to the circuit consisting of resistance 10 ohm and inductance 5 Henry connected in series. The time constant of the circuit is, tell me what is the value of the time constant for RL circuit? What is the time constant?
L by R.
L by R. Good. So L is 5 Henry, R is 10. That means 0.5. Okay, so this is the correct answer. Next, the superposition theorem satisfies the principle of which one? This one is the answer is B. Okay. Now, Next, the ratio of output voltage to input voltage boost converter. Okay, this one still not taught to you. I will discuss that today after the after discussing this paper. Okay, next, two alternating currents are represented by I1, I2. Okay, their values are given. So, which one is correct? Tell me. Which one is correct?
Sir, C.
C, okay. Let me draw this. See, this is your reference value. Okay. Now, I1 value is 30 degree. What? Lagging with the reference. Check here. I1 is here. It is minus theta 1. Okay. That means it is lagging. So, I am drawing it here. Okay. This is your minus 30 degree. Okay. Is that clear? This is your I1. Okay. Next, I2 value is sine omega t plus 30. That means I2 is 30 degree leading with respect to the reference. Now tell me which one is basically leading with respect to which one? See, the angle difference total is 60 degree, right? And I2 is leading. Check here, I2 is leading, isn't it? So, I can say that I2 leads
I1.
Right, I2 leads I1. How much angle? 60 degree.
60 degree.
Okay, is there any option like that? Is there any option like that?
So option
no.
B.
Yes, option
I1 D. Lags I2 by 60 degrees.
Exactly. Because other than this writing, I can also write that I1 lags I2 by angle 60 degrees. Okay, so B option is correct. Okay, now next one, the positive plates of nickel iron is made up of lead peroxide. This is the correct answer. Because just by looking at these options, you can easily tell. Okay, because see, nickel hydroxide, no. Okay, ferrous hydroxide, no. Potassium hydroxide, no. Nickel iron cell, they are using. Okay, so the positive plates, okay, that will be lead peroxide. That will not be lead peroxide, it is nickel hydroxide. Okay. Okay, you have to check it because I cannot remember. There is also confusion in my mind whether it is the correct one or not. Okay, the answer will be between the nickel hydroxide or lead peroxide. Okay, check that. Right. And if I get the answer, I will tell that in the group. Now, next one. The maximum efficiency of the transformer occurs when the iron loss equals to copper loss. Because what is the efficiency? Efficiency means it is the ratio of output to input. Okay. What is your output? That will be given. What is your input? That is nothing but your output plus two types of losses. Right. Another first one is iron loss. And second one is copper loss, Cu loss. Okay. Now, if you can create a condition where this iron loss quantity becomes equal to the copper loss quantity, that means the copper loss that is happening in your transformer equals to the core loss or iron loss, then only your maximum efficiency condition will be reached. Okay, it will be satisfied. So, answer is iron loss equals to copper loss. Right. Next, the frequency of EMF induced in the rotor of a 3-phase 50 hertz induction motor at standstill. Standstill means what is the slip? because it is asked that the EMF induced in the rotor, the frequency of the EMF induced in the rotor, and in rotor, what is your frequency? S into F. Okay. Now at standstill condition, what is your slip value? It is 1. Okay. So your frequency will be 50 hertz. Right. Next, the field of the synchronous generator is excited by obviously DC supply. Okay. In case of synchronous generator, the field is always supplied, always excited by using the DC supply. Okay. And what is the difference from this synchronous generator with the three-phase induction motor? In case of induction motor, what was the construction? The field coil is in the stator and armature coil is in the rotor. But in synchronous generator, it is totally opposite. Okay, the field coil is in the rotor and the armature coil is in the stator. That's why we get the output from the stator. Okay, so that is the total MCQ. Okay, here see the 5 marks question will not be given to you. Now see this question: a coil having resistance of 5 ohm and inductance 0.1 henry is connected in series with a 50 microfarad capacitor. Sinusoidal voltage 200 volt is applied. At what frequency the current in the circuit will be maximum? That means you have to develop the which condition? Resonant condition. Okay, because at resonant condition only you will get the maximum value of current, because the impedance will get minimum. Right? Then what is the current value and voltage across the capacitor at this frequency? You can calculate that. Okay. Next, the series circuit consisting of RL circuit. Okay, this was already shown you. See this one, yes. Find out the average and RMS voltage waveform. Okay, this is your sinusoidal voltage, but the difference is this negative cycle is omitted. This negative cycle is omitted. Okay, so what is your total time period? Total time period is obviously 2 pi. Okay, and since this is voltage, so I will say that Vt equals to what value is given? 10. Okay, 10 sinusoidal wave. Okay, this value is 10 sine omega t, right? And this value is only be possible when the time is in between 0 to pi. Okay, clear? Because from pi to 2 pi, this value is 0. From pi to 2 pi, this value is 0. So this is your voltage equation. Now based on that average, how to calculate the average value, how to calculate the RMS value, that formula is known to you. Okay, average value XAVG equals to integration 0 to T, okay, 1 by T, here it is XT dt. Okay, and what is the RMS value? That is X RMS equals to 1 by T integration X square T into dt. Limit will remain same, 0 to capital T, and this is your Q. Okay, so that's how you have to calculate. Next, the superposition theorem. So at a time you have to check, you have to take one source, either current source or voltage source. So based on that, you can calculate. Okay. Now the short circuit test, open circuit test, there will be no numerical like this big. Okay. Another numerical. Okay, this numerical can be given. See, this is Thevenin equivalent theorem. This is based on the Norton's theorem. Already, you are expert, I think, to solve this. Okay. This then this question. Okay, this is mesh connector. No, that is not required also. Okay. So that's all today. So thank you everyone. I will upload that two question papers in Google Classroom. Okay. If you have any doubt regarding any kind of question, you can ask me. Okay. And tomorrow I will take the class. Right. And this power converter, this section will be discussed. Okay. There are some topics from which your MCQs can be given in exam. Okay. So just this one, I have to discuss it. So thank you everyone. I am concluding today's class with this. If you have any question, you can ask. Or otherwise, you can give your attendance in the classroom.
Sir, you are right. The positive plate is nickel hydroxide.
Nickel hydroxide, no? Oh, okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Thank you. Okay, so all of you go through all the numericals that were in the papers. Okay, that two papers that I will upload maybe within 15 minutes or 20 minutes, I will upload that in classroom. Okay, and based on the module 5, all the PPTs were uploaded. Okay, and your tomorrow's class will be as per routine. Clear? So thank you everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.